Hello everyone, I am Rohit and welcome to my YouTube channel AI Era. In this particular video, we are going to see how to create a histogram from our dataset using a library called a matplotlib. So this is our second video in our data visualization series. So we are seeing in our first video how to plot a scatter graph or how to plot a scatter plot using matplotlib library in our dataset. So without doing any delay, just jump into our Jupyter node. So guys, here I am in my Jupyter node. So particularly, this is my second video about data visualization. So I name it data visualization second. And in last video, I will discuss with you a various types of plot, such as scatter plot, histogram, bar plot or bar graph. In my previous video, I can mention or I can explain a scatter plot. So the link is below in description. You can click on the link and you can watch this video to get more intuition about this. The next types of plot is the histogram. So what is histogram? So histogram is basically a graphical representation of data using bars of different heights. In histogram, we use a bars of different heights to represent our data. Histograms groups a number into range and height of each bar depicts the frequency of each range or bin. So we know by reading two sentences what is the histogram. The next step, when it's actually used or what is its practical application. The answer itself right over here. When to use histogram, the answer is to represent frequency distribution of numerical variables. When we have mentioned or when we have to represent a frequency distribution of different numerical variables, then we use the histogram. So to work with our data set in Jupyter Notebook, we require a certain library called Pandas, library called NumPy, and to plot histogram, we require a library called a matplotlib. So we import a necessary library by saying import pandas as pd, import numpy as np, import matplotlib.pyplot as pld. What is pandas? What is numpy? I will create the playlist on pandas and numpy on my YouTube channel, and I will create a playlist of both library, that is pandas and numpy. So it's my humble request to you to please access this library to get more intuition. Also, I can import a OS library. OS library is basically used to change or set a working directory. So here I am set my working directory, that is E drive in pandas folder. So I can change my or set my working directory by simply typing os.change directory, and in close parenthesis I have to give the directory path. Then for executing this cell, I have to press Shift Enter. When this asteroid is get converted into number, my cell is executed. So my asteroid is get converted into number 1 and my cell is executed. So I can import a necessary library successfully. Then to plot a histogram, I need a dataset. So I can import my dataset by simply saying df is equal to pd.read underscore csv. And in close parenthesis, I will have to mention my dataset. So if you saw my previous video, I use the weight and height dataset, and I particularly download this dataset from a Kaggle website. So for visualization of this dataset, I can use the command df.head. To execute this cell, I have to press a Shift Enter. So you can see over here, the df.head command will give me first 5 rows from my dataset with all features. So my dataset contains a 3 features: gender, height and weight. Basically in this dataset, the height is in my inches and weight is in my pounds. So the main concern about this video is to create a histogram. So here we not get more detail about the units or conversion of units in this video. So I can visualize my data. The next step is to create a histogram. So I can write a few lines of code. So if you recall, or if you see my last video for plotting a scatter plot, I will have to write a command such as plt.scatter. But in this particular video or in this particular code, I have to generate a histogram. Therefore, I have to write a command called plt.histogram. Then I have to mention a particular feature of which I have to require a histogram. So here I will require a histogram of my height feature. Then I have to mention edge color, that is white. Then the histogram color, that is, I have to mention over here a red, and required a total numbers of bins, means total numbers of bar is 25. Bins basically defines a numbers of bar are present in my, or required in my histogram. So I can mention a 25 bar in my histogram. I can label my data set as a height. So as a previous video, I can give a title to my I can give title to my graph or my histogram, such as histogram of height. Same as previous video, I can set x label or y label. The x label and y label both commands are particularly used to give the name of x axis and y axis, and by saying plt.show, I can generate my graph. So to execute this particular code or execute this particular cell, I have to press a shift enter, and you can see over here the histogram, which x-axis name is height, y-axis name is weight, and the title of histogram is height of histogram of height. So if I change the bin size, let's I mention a 20, and I can press a shift enter, then you can visualize it will create a 20 bins over here. So this is enough for today's video. If you like this video, please like it, share with your friend, and do subscribe my YouTube channel, that is Era Era. If you are having any doubts or any suggestions, please comment it out in comment box, and don't forget to press a bell icon and never miss any update. Thank you one and all.